Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm going to talk to you about a few of the properties of real numbers in this video. The first property that's pretty commonly known is the commutative property of addition. And the commutative property of addition in symbols, we would say A plus B equals B plus A. In words, I could describe that property by saying changing the order doesn't change the answer. That's true for addition. It would not be true for subtraction, but I could do that for addition. I could also do that for multiplication, so there's a commutative property of multiplication as well. The commutative property of multiplication says that A times B is equal to B times A. Remember, when we have the two letters side by side, it means multiply, even though we don't show a multiplication symbol, it's implied. And we're going to look at these, and then we'll look at some problems where we use them. The associative property of addition. Associative says that if we have A plus B plus C, that would equal A plus B plus C. So what we changed here is not the order, A, B, C, A, B, C. That did not change. What we changed was the grouping. In other words, here B was grouped with C, but on the other side B was grouped with A. So changing the grouping doesn't change the answer. If you have addition, you can change that grouping. It won't change the answer. Why would you ever do that? Well, let's say I had 4 plus 6 plus 83. Well, I might want to think of that as 4 plus 6 plus 83 because I know 4 plus 6 is 10. And then I could easily go, yeah, and 10 plus 83 is 93. It would just be easier for me than adding that and then adding the 4. Okay, so you can change that. And there's other reasons why we would do it, but just a day-to-day, I might change the order, or change the grouping, sorry. The associative property of multiplication, similar idea. If we have A times B times C, we don't change the order with associative, but we can change that grouping. Changing the grouping doesn't change the answer, whether you're working with addition or multiplication. Notice that these properties, the commutative and the associative, apply to addition and multiplication, not subtraction, not division. Additive inverses. Additive inverse is if you have opposites, A and negative A, and you add those together, you get 0. When you add opposites, you get 0. The multiplicative inverse says that if you have a number and you multiply it by its reciprocal, that is A times 1 over A, you get positive 1. Even if you were to have a negative 3, the reciprocal of negative 3 is negative 1/3. What is negative 3 times negative 1/3? It's positive 1. Every time you multiply something by its reciprocal, you always get a positive 1. When you multiply a number by its reciprocal, you get 1. Okay, let's try a couple of problems looking at these. Use the commutative property to rewrite the expression. Whoops, I shouldn't have left that ugly paper there. To rewrite the expression, so let's take a look at the expressions. We want to use a property, a commutative property in there. Okay, so if it's a commutative property, it means either the addition or the multiplication. We decide which one by looking at the sign that's in between there. This is addition. We're going to use the addition property of commutative, so we're going to change the order. The commutative says you can change the order without changing the answer. So that's the same. For the next one, it's multiply, so we're going to use the commutative property of multiplication. We're going to take this negative 3 and we're going to put it on the other side and we're going to put the x out front. I don't want that to look like a subtraction problem, so I want to make sure and put parentheses around it to show x times negative 3. For the last one, if I have BL, then I would change that to LB. That's all I would do to change that using the commutative property. Commutative property has to do with order. Look, commutative is order, CO. Okay, associative property. Use the associative property to rewrite the expression, and then they gave us these. Now remember, when you use the associative property, you're not changing the order. I'm still going to have 3, I'm still going to have x, I'm still going to have y, but I'm going to change the grouping. And so here, x and y were grouped together. In the second half, then, I'm going to group x with 3. I change the grouping, I left all the multiplication because I'm not changing the signs or anything. I'm just changing those grouping symbols. Here I'm going to have x and 5 and y. But here I had 5 was grouped with x. And so in the second half, 5 is going to be regrouped with y. That's using the associative property of addition. And now here, simplify by using more than one property. We have two different examples. For the first one, I'm going to use a few different properties. I'm going to rearrange this. I'm going to change the order, and I'm going to change the grouping. So I'm going to use associative and commutative, and I'm going to rewrite this as y plus negative 8 plus 8. So I just used the property that allows me to change the order, that's commutative, and the associative that changed the grouping. And the next thing I'm going to do is say, wow, well, I have opposites. So I've got the additive inverses going on. And when I have the additive inverses, I get 0. And finally, well, I don't need to put 0 because I have the property that says the identity property. So I would just write y. So all I really have to do is write y there. I'm using that. And here, if I want to use more than one property, I'm going to start off by regrouping. That's the associative property. And I know that anything times its own reciprocal gives me 1. So I just get 1x, which I can just state as x. So I can simplify those using more than one property. All right, have a fantastic day.